Hello, super quick intro. Today I'm going to be showing you how you can solve the Hanayama Seahorse Puzzle, which means I'm going to give you the sequence of moves that will separate these and the most efficient way of actually doing it. Then I'll show you how you can do the reverse to reconnect them and get them back to their original position. And without further ado, let's get on with that solution. Okay, so here we have a fully assembled seahorse puzzle, and the fully assembled position is the silver tail connecting to the gold head. And what we're going to do is the four moves that are required to separate these two. And we're going to do it in a way that's hopefully easy to follow. We're going to keep the silver piece still. We're going to have it so that the head is facing towards us, and the head is also on the left-hand side as we're looking down on it. So that piece is going to stay still, and we're going to be moving the gold piece around the silver piece. So first of all, we're going to lift the gold piece up so it's parallel with the silver piece. We're going to slide over that fin in there. And then what we're going to do is we're going to let the gold seahorse drop down. And angles are important in all of these moves. So if it doesn't quite feel right immediately, then just play around with the angle of the gold piece. What we're going to do is we're going to lift and push the gold piece through the silver tail until we're in this position. And then when we're here, we're going to keep it horizontal to go over this fin. And we can then let it drop down onto the right-hand side of the tail in this position here. So that's move one done. Next, what we're going to do is we're going to cross from the silver tail over to the silver head. And again, angles are extremely important with this one, but we're now going to use the gap in the gold piece to slide out and over the silver tail. So we're here, essentially in no man's land. And then what we need to do is turn the corner and pretty much mirror the position that we did to come out of the silver tail to get into the silver head in this position. And now we're at the halfway point. Two moves down, two moves to go. We're going to lift the gold piece out and then come around into this position. Once we're in this position, we're going to lift the gold piece up. We should have, it's quite tight, but we should have enough room to lift in that position. We're going to go over the horn of the silver seahorse. And then from this position, all we're going to do is we're just going to let the gold piece drop down into here. And we can then come out and over the horn into this position. And for the final move, I'm just going to hold it slightly differently and hopefully in a way where I'm not blocking anything. But now for the gold piece, we need to flip it over the top. Again, hopefully I don't get in the way here. Into this position here. And again, angle is extremely important. We need the gold piece to be over in this position or somewhere over here before we can then slide down. And I'll turn it slightly, and then we can cross the two pieces there, and that is how we separate the seahorse puzzle. And for reassembling the seahorse puzzle, we're going to do it in much the same way. We're going to be holding the seahorse in this position. The head is facing us and towards the left-hand side as we're looking down on it. And we're going to be just moving the gold piece around the silver piece as we go along. So the first move, all we're going to do is we're going to reconnect them to start with. We're going to have the two seahorses facing each other. And then we're going to come over, tilt it so that the gold head is down and over into this position. So that's how we reconnect them. We then need to change the angle to sort of northwest even. So that we can then connect the head to the head in this position in here. We can then come around into here, this position. And while we've got the heads connected, we now need to get it so that the silver head connects to the gold tail. And for that, essentially we need to get into this position. And again, angle is important, but it's more, you'll figure it out as you go along with this one, is we just need to lift the gold piece through the silver head. And then we can come around that corner and into this position here. It might stay in this position because it's quite tight. If it doesn't and it drops down to here, then all we need to do is just lift it back up to this position before we then come over this silver head fin. Once it's in like a parallel position, let it drop down because that's required for the next move. So the next move, what we need to do is move the gold piece from the silver head to the silver tail. And to do that, And again, angle is very, very important. We need to be in this position. We're going to come over that gap and into what I've been referring to as no man's land before we then mirror that position to connect to the silver tail in this position in here. Once we're here, we've just got one move to do. We're going to come lift it when it's in a parallel position. That's the only place you can lift it before we slide over this fin. And then all we need to do is lift the gold piece up and let it drop. Again, when it's in the right angle, we let it drop into the silver tail. And to finish it off, we're just going to come around the silver fin. And we have a fully reassembled seahorse puzzle. So there it is. That is how you disassemble and then reassemble the Hanayama seahorse puzzle. As I said before, it's quite the sequence of moves. There's quite a variety of moves as well, all about swapping sides on various different levels. And hopefully this has helped you solve the Hanayama seahorse puzzle for yourself. If you have any questions or any issues with the solution, then comment below and I will do what I can to answer your question or help where you need help. And thank you very much for being here. If you want to see me struggle through the seahorse puzzle for the first time, or the solutions for any of these other Hanayama puzzles, then be sure to click my face here to subscribe, and I will see you next time. Peace!